Hi folks, this is Keith Berkelheimer from Reefbum, and I am once again collaborating with Marine Depot on an educational video about reef keeping. In this video, I'm going to continue our series about SPS and dive into some things to consider about testing water parameters. Today, there are a few options available for keeping tabs on how a tank is doing. Perhaps the most common method is to use hobby-grade test kits like those from Saltwater. For many years, I used these kits to monitor key SPS parameters such as calcium, alkalinity, magnesium, phosphate, and nitrate. They are simple to use and can produce results in a few minutes. But advances in the hobby have made lab-grade testing available to reef keepers. I consider alkalinity to be one of the most important elements to monitor on a constant basis, and a few years ago, I started to use the KH Director from GHL. Another option is the Alcatronic from CoralView. With these types of units, you can not only test one time per day, but multiple times per day, a great option for reefers who typically test once a week with hobby-grade kits. Another huge benefit with these automated devices is the option to control alkalinity based on test results. A doser hooked into an alkalinity monitor can adjust the amount of alkalinity being dosed to maintain a certain DKH, which is a measure of alkalinity. A calcium reactor can be controlled in a similar manner. Having the ability to maintain rock-solid alkalinity levels with this adaptive control feature is huge, since SPS react very badly when there are large swings in alkalinity. Here are some examples of frags that got pissed off and faded due to an alk swing. SPS can even start to RTN, which stands for rapid tissue necrosis, due to significant shifts in alkalinity. For my tanks, I like to keep alk at 8.5 DKH, and with my KH Director, it stays locked in at that level. The Trident from Neptune is another lab-grade monitor slash controller that can measure and control alkalinity. However, it can also measure calcium and magnesium, two other elements important for keeping a healthy SPS tank. GHL's Ion Director, due to be released this fall, will take it a step further. This unit will measure calcium, magnesium, potassium, sodium, and nitrate. But there is more. An ICP test will deliver the most comprehensive analysis you can get for an aquarium. What is an ICP test? ICP stands for inductively coupled plasma, and testing is done using plasma that is heated to 10,000 degrees Kelvin. It literally rips molecules apart, providing the most accurate saltwater aquarium test results available. Triton has an ICP test that provides precise views into 36 different key elements. Triton also sells additives that can be used to adjust different elements up or down based on the test results. CoralView has a new ICP water analysis that can test 40 plus elements, while ATI has one that tests 43 parameters. Every few months, I do like to order an ICP test, whether the tank is looking good or not. It makes sense to do a test when the tank is doing well, since the data will provide a baseline versus results generated when the tank is not doing so well. So that is a brief overview on the different testing options. One important point I always like to make is to not underestimate the power of observation. Use your eyes to help gauge the health of a tank and avoid chasing numbers by targeting very specific data points. Instead, seek parameters within acceptable ranges. For the next video in this series, I will take a deeper dive into ICP testing and go through the tests I did to help troubleshoot some issues I was having with my tank a couple of years ago. Well, folks, that will do it for this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. I'll put links to Marine Depot and Reefbum in the video description below. Many thanks for watching. See you next time.